heaven that you wanna go. I'm going out the country, baby, don't you wanna go. I'm going to some place where I've never been before.
Now, think about what they just said. Folding bends many layers of rock without breaking them. What you just heard is the most cockamamie, poppycock, impossible thing, lie, stupid thing any evolutionist has ever, ever, ever said.
And yet, over many decades, hundreds and hundreds of experiments on all kinds of rocks have been conducted, and they all demonstrate that all kinds of different sorts of rocks, when subjected to high confining pressure, like in a tectonic event, and high temperature, like rocks when they get buried at great depth, become very ductile. They become enormously plastic, and they do, in fact, bend. And these articles are not difficult to find. There are research articles all over the place. You could probably get access to them through your local library. You can even find some of them on the internet. The fact that you have not done so, Neph, tells me that you either haven't done your research, you don't want to know, or you looked at the math in some of these guys and you got scared.
I think it's important that I pointed out that NASA webpage made the claim that mountains can fold without breaking the rock. That's not even common sense, folks. And it's not possible either.
And therein lies why we find you so obnoxious, Neph. Here's something you clearly don't understand. You are incredulous about. But you don't ask a question, how is this sort of thing even possible? No, you just make a blanket statement that it's impossible because it doesn't fit in with the mythology of some ancient desert-dwelling sheep herders.
You see, this is conclusive proof that every mountain range and every mountain of the earth rose in virtually no time at all. So fast, in fact, that gravity did not have time to suck the water out of the mountain. The strata from the bottom of the mountain to its very peak were plastic as the mountain rose fully.
I think you have a rather cartoonish image in your head of how folded mountains get formed. It isn't simply that the sediments are squeezed together and pushed upward into folds. That's not how it works. Actually, the rocks are being pushed downward to great depth, and under high confining pressure and temperature, they become very plastic and they fold. As erosion removes overlying material, this material forced to depth, which is actually depressing the rocks of the mantle, which are far more dense, begins to rise. And as it rises, continued erosion creates the ridges and valleys because of differential weathering of different types of rock, because some rocks, like sandstone, are very resistant to weathering, while lots of rocks like limestone are less resistant. It's like the Great Valley of Tennessee, where the valleys are limestone and the ridges are sandstones and metamorphics and in some cases granites. Alrighty, Nephster. What's the ultimate proof that these folded mountains were subjected to huge pressures and heat? Within the hearts of all these mountain chains, the rocks have been so intensely deformed that they've actually been chemically altered. They've been metamorphosed by the heat and pressure. And minerals that only form under gigantic pressures and heat are present in these rocks. Minerals like starolite, kyanite, andalusite, sillimanite. There's your proof, Neph. And if you knew even the first thing about rocks and geology, you'd have known that. Now let's briefly look at your model of how folded mountains occurred. According to you, the North American continent was forced westward from the Mid-Atlantic Ridge and eventually encountered obstacles or friction that pushed up the mountain ranges. So according to you, the Rocky Mountain chain, the Basin Range province to the west, and the Sierra Nevada to the west of that, and finally the coastal ranges of California were all forced up into folds in the same titanic, earth-shattering event. But so were the Appalachians. How is it that the entire center of the continent escaped this carnage? How is it that the rocks are relatively undisturbed, flat-lying, and have very little topographical relief? And then suddenly, on the trailing edge of the continent, away from where all the friction and deformation should have occurred, we find the Appalachians. How about this area in the circle? Now, this is the Basin and Range province, and these mountains and valleys are not created by folding of sedimentary rocks. Instead, they're created by faulting. North-south trending faults that create uplifted blocks and downlifted blocks as the continent of North America slowly pulls itself apart. How does that fit in with your rapid creation of folded mountains, Neff?
Many of them contain erratic boulders trapped inside the mountain at various levels in the strata.
Bullshit, Neff. You're talking straight out of your ass. And I do believe I've looked at a lot more rocks and a lot more mountains than you have.
The evolutionists at NASA made a crazy, absurd statement that is actually a lie, made in the name of uniformitarianism and evolutionism.
No, chubby hubby. They simply made a statement based upon massive amounts of field work over a couple of centuries. Incredible amounts of research and experimentation in laboratories and some basic chemistry and mineralogy. And you can't accept the simple facts because it contradicts your desperate clinging to the myths of some ancient sheep herders. You'd rather believe that an educated Bronze Age sheep herders know more about the structure of the earth than modern geology. You're pathetic. Neff, I honestly don't know how many more responses of this sort I can make to you. Frankly, you bore the shit out of me. You know nothing. You're arrogant as hell. You dismiss the education and real-life field experience of people who have dedicated their life to this field. You're unwilling to become educated. You just may well be the saddest bastard on YouTube. The only reason I've responded to you lately at all is people keep requesting that I respond to you. Do us all a favor. Get off your spotty ass, put down the headphones, get out of that dark and lonely room, and find yourself a fucking life.
Well, he's just an excitable boy.